Let us welcome the team from China. Lin Dan, Chai Yu, Fu Haiken, Po Chunlai, Song Yang, Chen Po, Xia Xuan Chen, Chen Hong, Chen Qi Chu, Chen Yu. And also we would like to welcome Denmark. Peter Kent, Lars Pass, Jonas Rasmussen, Kenneth Jonasson, James Eriksson, Martin Lugard, Peter Rasmussen. And also we'd like to welcome Mr. Quanta Francis, the president of IBM, and Mr. Henry Tanjung of PBSI to congratulate the two teams. Now the two team will exchange souvenir. Thank you very much for your attention. And the two team may return to the seats. And hope all of you enjoy every game of the match of the 2004 Bang Mandri Thomas and Uber Cup. Thank you.
Bridge the dreams for the nation glory. Bridge the dreams for the nation glory. Bridge the dreams for the nation's glory. Bridge the dreams for the nation's glory. Keep out of my hero. Keep the bright lights on spirit on. With all that you make, with all that you share, we burn flame inside. Keep out of my hero. Remember you'll never be alone. Here is where we stay. Together we will be for the nation. Where we'll stand. Keep out of my hero. Keep the bright lights on spirit on. With all the steps you make, with all the sweat you share, with burning flame inside. Keep out of my hero. Remember you'll never be alone. Here is where we'll stay. Together we will be. For the nation we will stand. Keep out the fight, my hero. Down the far side of the wall, down there is Peter Gaines.
running and dance statistics. 8 years away from a World Junior bronze medalist. His favourite to take that title from the World Junior Championships in 2000 were played in China. So Darren, I know that at the hotel you were chatting to Peter Gaylor earlier today, and he was disappointed in his loss to Sonny Bunkoro, but he didn't have a bit of a stomach upset. But we think he's absolutely fit now.
Yeah, absolutely. I spoke to him early on this afternoon. He said he wasn't happy with his match against the Indonesia. He didn't feel 100%, but he's fully recovered now, feeling a lot better and looking forward to tonight's match.
And then all 12 teams go through to a knockout competition, but the top of each of the four groups gets a bye into the quarterfinal stage, and it really has been an outstanding success, this new format.
Yeah, absolutely, Jill. Well, it's made a massive difference with countries from five continents now being able to compete in the Thomas Cup final. In the past, it's been three from Asia, three from Europe, and Austin, a holder, so only 8 teams, so it's opened it wide up, giving the other countries chances to play in these Thomas Cup finals.
Best of five matches, of course, three singles and two doubles. The order of play goes first singles, first doubles, second singles, second doubles, and if we need to go the distance, the third singles. Garesh Nathu of India, the umpire for this match. These two players have met each other 5 times previously, and Lin Dan holds the advantage, having won 4 of those encounters. And perhaps significant that he's won, the 4 that he's won have been the last 4. Peter Gaylor, lovely to see him back to full fitness after that knee operation on his right knee. Had a lot of time out during 2001 and 2002, and in fact last year had to qualify for a number of Grand Prix tournaments. It seems quite incredible, but of course the entry lists for Grand Prix events are taken directly from the world ranking, and the world ranking done over a 12-month period, so of course if a player has 12 months off with injury, then they've got to work their way back up the world ranking. The Thomas Cup. Sir George Thomas donating the cup to the International Badminton Federation for the men's team championship.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the right, Denmark, represented by Peter Gaylor. On my left, China, represented by Lin Dan. to serve. Love all. Play.
The Thomas Cup final begins. And immediately, Peter Vader, what final he brings.
Lovely confident start from Peter. Right away, being very positive. Playing lovely on the attack. Lovely winning set.
Their net plate, but that was outstanding.
Yeah, that's one of Lindau's favourite shots. Very, very deceptive. Holds it for a stiff stop at the last second.
One,
up. Yeah, Peter going up. Lovely reverse slice. Steep into the low 14 corner of Lindau.
Very loose, slow serve.
Able to contain Lindau's attack, get down the sides, finally lovely net shot, gets the lift, but up he goes very early in the forehand corner. Just beat smash. That's a good shot.
Do you think it's Gator's tactics to come out and dictate the pace where he wants to be commanding the rallies?
Yeah, he won't want to sit back and hope to see what happens. He's got to try some pull good to try and get this part as well. Look at the championship. Lindau has started a little bit slow in the first game. So we'll have looked at that. We can try and get a lead and hold on to it. Great smash, short lift back from Lindau, then goes cross court, gives the right idea of attack.
Play.
He is so deceptive from the front of the court. The head coach for the Chinese team, former world men's doubles champion.
Thank you.
First, he may feel we'll go for it in two, all out attack. Very deceptive. So two dishes, one stop net shot. Very lovely spinning net shot.
Puts into every single rally, sprawling across the water in an effort to try and retrieve it.
confidence in mid-band. Not quite steadied himself yet. Still early stages of nerves. Can't quite freeze him in. We talked about the nerves, Darren, certainly in the Euro Cup final yesterday between China and Korea. I think there's so much expectation for China to prove their dominance in World Badminton, but certainly the women's squad, the Euro Cup squad, did look very nervous, and so you're right. I wonder if Lin Dan is feeling the same sort of pressure.
Yeah, it just doesn't look quite relaxed yet. He's normally flowing, so.
Said it has started a little bit slow as the ball is going to go on in the recent matches.
Five
got better and better.
Onto the net shot. Incredible angle, cross court net.
7-5.
Apart from the length of the court, there is a sideways drift as well.
Thank you.
to the speed of the server. So if the receiver isn't ready, it's tough.
Yes, that's right. And I think that's what it's going to Lindan. Peter Gay has got to start with his hands ready to serve. But Lindan's just not quite set his position, putting his hand up. The referee wants him to get on with it a bit quicker.
My goodness, how high in the air did Lindan jump to thunder down the smash? Support here in the stadium for Denmark and of course for China. And it's interesting, before play started, Darren, we were seeing the Danish players, both the Super Cup squad and the rest of the Danish Cup squad, going around the arena here, throwing some of their Danish team shirts into the crowd and really trying to drum up some support for them.
Really, they've done very well. I think after beating Indonesia, crowd have adopted them a little bit, and there are plenty of support for them here in the final.
6-9, play.
Well, the problem for Gaeta is that it is so important that we know that Lindan is exceptionally deceptive and fun before he yet. If he starts running off with a high serve, then equally the Chinese player has this ability to leap in the air and find incredible angles. He does that, of course, the perspiration from his shirt will stay on the court surface. And on the court, he needs attention. An obvious moment. They will also take a time out themselves. So.
minute lift was too short. Right onto the forehand side. Mid band. Scared that cross short smash. That was a great effect. Inviting Peter to play the net, looking for that kill. That rally, it was fantastic, trying to get himself going. And it's had the desired effect. Run. Six. In there at the moment, in full flow. Yeah, absolutely, this is a confident mid band now. He's happy with the way things are going. He's settled down. Close line call. He did look a bit frustrated.
Yeah.
proceedings.
Link.
Peter Connor take it early, put the pressure back, nice push, got the short return, nice cross to Smith to finish. As you say, Grossman took out some play of his serve. He's got to pick off balance a little bit. Slices through the shoulder, looks like he's going to hit a clear. Lindan stepped back, took the pace and power off it.
A long, hard look. But Darren, we're in a very good position in on the creek. He looked straight down that line. I think it's correct for.
Yeah, look, it could look bang on the line from here. Good input to go out.
Game. 15-8. odd yesterday.
Twenty seconds. Second game. Love all. Play.
Coach and staff didn't spend long with Lindan. Obviously, very happy with his team in that opening game. It was 15-8.
One, done.
He looked so confident in doing so. The last few points after winning the rally, you can see him jogging on the spot, going for a little jog around the court.
Service over. Love, one.
First time he's been really loose with his net plate.
Lindan
took a couple that might have been going out.
Yeah, it looked to be drifting out the side. A little bit of hesitancy from him. Manages to flick it over the head of Peter Gaider. Peter Gaider asking to change the scuttle.
Late.
Lindan saying no.
There's a little bit of tension between these two players out on court.
Yes, you're right. It's just a few things happening, a few staring at each other after the rally a little bit. Again, Peter wanted to change the shuttle. Lindan said no, went to the referee. He said no, fine, play on.
That's net shot was brilliant.
children. 1-3.
Developing into a battle of the next mate.
Yeah, now I'm going to give the list away. Pitt kept his patience, but kept it going down. Got the net shot. Too early. Lovely tight spinning net from him. Anticipate the drop, right thing to do. Lift the body of Lee Fan, but just pushed it too long. Saying yeah, both players want to change the shuffle, I have no problem. But of course there has been disagreement earlier on in the game between the two players as to whether to change the shuffle or not, which is why Peter Gaydup asked the umpire. Spinning over, Peter done well to get it back.
Subs over.
But really no chance of the
moving his opponent so well in that rally. Forced him to play the backhand and then immediately switch the angle to play across court. Well, I think Nada there saying three times in Dan has dived late. Right. in the four-man corner for the return, didn't move, saw the gap, really could have been a foot in. Coming to the net, holding Peter in the middle. As soon as Peter twitches off it goes, totally deceiving him. Peter able to get up and bring it down. Quite an easy winner for him.
Are asking to change the shuttle. Windan says no, so it's up to the umpire to make the decision. He indeed says the shuttle is not perfect to change it. He's going to get a yellow card here.
Warning from the
stand. Warning from the umpire. Too often he hasn't been ready when Peter Gaeta is wanting to serve.
In five.
let's clarify first what the yellow card means. It's just a warning after being unofficially warned. It's an official warning, is it?
That's right. It's like, as you say, first of all, the umpire said to him, get ready to get out. He obviously ignored it. Then he brings out the yellow card the second time. But actually, then he gets a red card, which is a point deduction.
A point automatically to his opponent,
yes,
rather than at his score.
Yes, so a point goes to his opponent as he gets a red card.
5.
Dan trying to influence the line judge by saying that it may have gone long. I think it was inside the tram line.
Yeah, great shot from Peter.
Just have a look at that. Yeah, still the ring.
Yeah, a lot of people would wait for it, take it on their backhand side, but not Lindan. He wants to punish it. Gets round there quickly. Good strong smash.
Well, Peter Gator said that he didn't want to cut the chain. So Lindan asked the umpire, and then Peter Gator is saying that Lindan is squashing the shuttle.
Late.
No wonder it's not a good shuttle any longer.
Six, three.
Three times now, Peter's left it and it's landed smack on the back line.
Gets to the net first and takes the shuttle early. He's then commanding the rally from that moment onwards.
Yeah, he is making a push for it. Very clever play. Got to the net early, held it. Saw Lindan moving forward. He played a superb net rally before. That time he gets there.
Good land just out. Lindan, long list of very talented Chinese left-handed players. Of course, we started with Yang Yang and then Zhao Jinhua, and now we've got two very talented left-handers in the Thomas Cup team, both Lindan obviously and Zhao Jinhua. Seems to be a trait of the Chinese that they're able to produce these very deceptive left-handers.
Well, they're great left-handers, do it better, and it does seem to be way the players they're producing. Really good players with fantastic shots.
Feathers going in exactly the same way, left over right, the 16 feathers in the shuttlecock, and therefore when they slice across the shuttle, it's different to a right hand, it produces different spins. Sometimes you're going with the feathers and sometimes going against the feathers.
Yeah, that's exactly right, Jill. So they hit it and it sometimes comes out a little bit more crisper.
Apologises for the good fortune of having hit the top of the table and just going over. And it's interesting, Dan, we've just seen the manager going through to the tournament referee and saying, just watch him down. When he gets a new shuttle, he's tipping the feathers. Now that slows the shuttle down, but he's not supposed to do that.
No, you're not supposed to do that at all. You know, obviously he's not happy with the speed of the shuttles. He's trying to slow them down a little bit. He's hitting a few arrows long out the back, but you're not supposed to be doing that.
Tournament referee Keith Hawthorne of England sitting right behind the court, keeping an eye on the proceedings.
Thank you.
get his racket with it. Dives out to the side, just got it back. Peter was there, thought the drift might take it out and landed on the line.
In that he does always want to jump in the air as he's hitting from the back of the court.
Yeah, very attacking style sometimes. Just so up he goes, great, good angle himself. Also, Peter, very fast into the net. His confidence has grown in the net. Oh,
play, so now it's the game.
Yeah, definitely. The tempo of the game's definitely lifted over the last 5 or 6 plays, but it's suited Peter Gaber.
Please. The line does it out. He's done the job for China. He did what was expected of him as world number one. And he's taken the opening match in the Thomas Cup final, 15-8, 15-13, against the number one Dane, Peter Gaeder. By throwing his t-shirt to the crowd.